Even non-bakers become bakers during the holiday season. This time of year, everyone is making cookies, cakes, and pies. But if you want a real showstopper, I have three magic words for you. Chocolate hazelnut cheesecake. This thing is superbly impressive and comes together really quickly. So for the crust, we have to have crust for a good cheesecake. I'm actually using granola. So I have 1 cup of this double chocolate crunch granola. And this is from ALDI's Live G-Free line, which happens to be their gluten-free line. So this goes into a food processor, and then give it a whirl. Okay, once you have some good granola dust, we're going to add 3 tablespoons of melted butter, and then give it a whirl again, just to hold everything together. Okay, crust is good to go. And now it's just time to go into a pan. So I have a 6-inch cheesecake pan with one of those false bottoms, or you could use a spring form. I've lightly greased it and then wrapped foil around the bottom just to prevent any leakage. So you just want to get every last bit of this out. And then we're just going to pat this crust down in the bottom of our cheesecake pan. Okay, our crust is packed down. I can see so much texture down there. It'll be nice and crunchy. Oven is set to 350, and this just goes in for 5 minutes to get nice and crunchy. Now it is time to make batter. Because we're going into the food processor, it can all go in cold, and it can all go in at once. So 2 nice big blocks of cream cheese. And then we need a little bit of salt, 1/4 teaspoon, and then 1/2 cup of sugar. We're going to add the sweetness in another form. We are using 1 whole jar of this hazelnut spread. I adore this stuff. Everybody loves this stuff. And this is what is going to give our cheesecake that great hazelnut flavor. So the whole thing goes in. And this is ordinarily kind of a splurge buy for me, but at ALDI, it's really inexpensive. And then we also need a couple eggs. 2 eggs, just to lighten up our cheesecake a little bit. And then the last thing that goes in is just a little bit of sour cream, just 1/4 cup. So now we're just going to blend it all together. And then we will go ahead and load our batter right onto the crust. So just smooth the top of this really nicely. And then I've just set this little 6-inch pan into a 9 by 9 inch baking dish. And then that way we'll be able to add some water to our baking dish so that we can bake this in a water bath. So into the oven we go. Set your cheesecake on. And then I've got my water here on standby. We'll just fill it about 1 to 1.5 inches up the sides of the pan. 45 minutes or until it's no longer jiggly in the center. Okay, I baked this guy until it was no longer jiggly, and then chill it thoroughly for longer than you think. And then I'm going to go ahead and unmold it. And we're going to unmold. Watch the magic happen. So we have this dense, nice, high, beautiful cheesecake. I'm just going to transfer it to a plate. We're gonna take this thing to a stunner. So I am using these cream wafer rolls. And this is what I love about ALDI. There's all kinds of really unique items. So you can cut these to the height of that cheesecake, and then we're basically building a little cookie fence. So what I do after this then is get just a length of raffia. I'm just using craft raffia today. And this will make sure all these little guys stay nice and snug on our cheesecake. We are going to garnish it with more chocolatey things. So I love the chocolate aisle at ALDI. That's probably where I spend most of my money. There's always a different kind of chocolate to buy, and I love that there's so many different German imports, and I'm just chopping this up, and then we'll pile this in the center. This might be the prettiest cheesecake I've ever made. But the cookie garnish and this particular chocolate bar does have wheat in it. So if you wanted to keep this recipe gluten-free, what you could do is make minis. So the crust doesn't have any gluten, neither does the cheesecake batter. So you can make the crust just like I did it, press it into mini cheesecake pans, and then use 1/2 the batter. So cut the batter recipe in 1/2, and then just garnish it with a bar that's just made of chocolate and nuts. And then you have something for your guests who are on a gluten-free diet. And ALDI's exclusive gluten-free line, Live G-Free, actually makes holiday entertaining really easy for people who have dietary restrictions. So there's all kinds of great ideas like gluten-free baking or this beautiful holiday dessert on ALDI's website, ALDI.us, or like ALDI on Facebook.